keep it down.
There's Henrik straight up the middle. Bravada falls in behind. Henrik to the net. Bernier got a piece of that and sent it to the corner. Back the other way. David Farkson stopped in the neutral zone by Lucas Pisa. Joffrey Lupo to Dion Phaneuf, who jumps up. Parkson off the wing, snaps a shot, an easy save for Miller. Knocked down by Burrows, couldn't clear the puck. Holland with a shot, he scores! Well, they took one away from him in the first period. They won't take that away. Peter Holland, 3-0 Toronto.
Never a bad play to put the puck in the net. And David Clarkson going one-on-one just inside the line. Gets a high shot that Miller tries to get away from traffic. Burrows can't control it. And right through the screen of Kevin Bieksa. Glenn, I'm sure you had a perfect vantage point. An absolute rocket up and over the glove.
All about placing the puck where you want to place it. Holland knew where he wanted to put it before he shot it. Perfectly placed. Head up. Miller doesn't track it. Not going to stop what you don't see.
And the ascension of Peter Holland up the Toronto lineup continues as he gets more and more ice time from Randy Carter.
You get good competition within the lines.
And again, they took that first period goal away from him because it was knocked in by Yannick Weber, but he gets this one and makes it 3-0.
Last year at this time, the Leafs were a one-trick pony. One-line team. Talk about Vancouver's depth. How about Toronto's depth? Four lines that can hurt you and score.
Some Kadri who was able to take advantage of it, and now another chance. One thing that when you have a turnover right in your slot for the goaltender, Glenn, I'm sure you can attest to, you're not quite prepared to come out and challenge as much. There's the rebound that Miller thinks he's all set. He gets back in his net, he gets very small, and a perfect shot was made.
Well, that's a sloppy play, and there's been a couple sloppy plays. This is an odd fall, and I think Edler just lost his wind. He went back to the bench. He was okay. He got back out, and it was right moments after that that Weber missed a really good chance in front of that with some sloppy lead play.
Behind 3-0, it's not like the Canucks haven't had any chances.